Good afternoon. I apologize for a little late. I was looking for my tie and couldn't find one. There's so many people here. Every phone call I had, I said, please keep this confidential, but somehow you all got noticed. Thank you for being here with us this afternoon. You're all aware of the gravity of the COVID-19 crisis around the world and right here in Nevada. I've taken what I believe were the necessary steps to try to mitigate this pandemic and keep our community safe, including closing our K-12 schools and recommending that we follow social distancing guidelines. Today, it is clear additional steps must be taken immediately in order to slow the spread of this deadly virus in our state, not to go up. You owe it to them to listen to that directive. I've spoken with the chief medical officers of all of Nevada's hospitals to get their assessment of our current situation and most responsible next steps. They have advised me that the most effective course of action is to direct all Nevadans to stay home and for non-essential businesses to close to the public.
Only essential services
should remain open, such as fire, police, transit, and health care services, in addition to businesses that provide food, shelter, or social services for disadvantaged populations. Non-essential services, such as beauty shops, barber shops, nail, tanning, waxing salons, should close until further notice. Only essential businesses should remain open, such as pharmacies, grocery stores, drug and convenience stores, banks and financial institutions, hardware stores, and gas stations. All gatherings should be postponed or canceled. This is not the time for sleepovers, play dates, concerts, theater outings, or athletic events. Although you might not be experiencing symptoms at this time, you may be contagious. Do not risk your health or the health of others. Many of you will not be in your office or work over the next few weeks. This is not a vacation, and it's not a time to catch up with friends. It's definitely not the time to go to the movies. Every social contact increases your risk of exposure. The bigger the group, the higher the risk. The time when people are getting sick from simply being near others is not the time for gyms to remain open. This is not the time for casinos to remain open. This is not the time for community recreation centers, clubhouses, movie theaters, and malls to remain open. If your business brings groups of people together, it should not. We are strong. We are resilient. We will get through this. I want to note, this is likely my last press conference in person. To protect my staff, to protect members of the media, we will continue to update all of our Nevadans through other methods, including videos, emails, and at the dedicated Nevada Health Response website, nvhealthresponse.nv.gov. Thank you for joining us here this evening. I take a few questions.
Governor, how do you enforce this? How do you keep people from leaving their homes? How do you enforce this?
I think that the people of Nevada understand how serious this is, and that if they care about their own well-being, if they care about the well-being of their loved ones, they will heed this advice from the best medical professionals in the United States and in the world. Stay home, prevent the spread of the disease.
And Governor, the closure of casinos includes those in downtown Las Vegas, Fremont Street?
Casinos?
Fremont Street, does that include the...
Casino closure involves every casino in the state of Nevada. Every gaming piece of equipment in the state of Nevada.
We've seen large crowds there still at this hour, so effective by noon tomorrow, you said?
I'll repeat, every gaming device must be turned off by midnight tonight. The casinos will not be open and have any gambling activity. That includes the bars, includes the convenience stores, includes the grocery stores. All gaming operations must cease by midnight tonight.
Governor.
I don't know if I can make this any clearer, that people are looking for a loophole here. This is affecting the lives of our citizens. People are dying. You know, every day that is delayed here, I'm losing a dozen people on the back end that are going to die as a result of this. Kevin Durant, one of the most fit people in the world, tested positive today. It's incumbent upon the citizens of this state to take this seriously. Next question.
Governor Sisolak, do you see this as a precursor to more drastic quarantine measures
like we've seen in the Bay Area.
These are the measures that I was advised by the medical professionals that we contacted, that we hope we can get a handle on the spread of this epidemic with these, this pandemic with these actions, and we'll be evaluating this on a continuous basis.
Governor, do you support a federal bailout for the casino industry similar to one that the airlines and cruise industries could receive?
I'm not here to talk about money and bailouts today. I'm not here to talk about the health and well-being of the people of the state of Nevada. Our folks that live here, our folks that work here, that's my primary concern.
Governor, some elected officials have differed with you in with the seriousness publicly talking about whether to shut down restaurants and bars. Are you comfortable that everyone's singing from the same sheet of music?
I don't know what sheet they're singing from, John, but I can tell you this. As governor of the state of Nevada, it is my responsibility to protect the health and well-being of every person in the state, and this is serious. If somebody doesn't understand the seriousness of this, turn on the news and watch it for a little bit. It's incumbent upon us to protect ourselves, our families, and our most vulnerable populations, and I encourage everybody to participate. Stay home for Nevada. Thank you all very much.